Hello everyone, my name is Miri Rangwal and I'm from Uttarakhand. I was part of the first batch for Digital Swaraj Fellowship 2023-2024. And under this fellowship, I was a part of the project known as DIGI, that stands as a Digital Cluster Development Program in three locations of Tamil Nadu, namely Salem, Pattamadai and Udi. My project have basically two major segments. First, dealing with how we include the digital space, the pros of that to the communities which are not that much connected to the mainstream society in terms of getting the benefits out of the digital space. And that we have done by tools like literacy, entrepreneur skills, awareness, etc. I have been fortunate enough to see this project getting started from the scratch, where I was part from understanding the socio-economic landscape of the communities, finding an appropriate space for the cluster establishment that includes a lot of challenges in itself, but then finally overcoming all of them to set up centers and then progressing how we include those communities, how we gain their trust, how we communicate our messages, and then moving forward to provide them services, workshops, awareness and other benefits. Second part of the project deals with the artisans, the weavers who are working in these three locations producing GI tag products, namely Salem Silk, Pattamadai Pai and the Toda Embroidery of the Udi. My project is a wholesome experience of how we can connect the digital space, that is your tech part, to the traditional part of all these locations, which are extremely blessed in terms of artisans and their handicrafts. I think my inspiration or the initial take of joining the fellowship came from the core that I've always been keen about the social sector, and I still aspire to be a part of this. And when I was looking out for fellowship options, the word digital grabbed my attention, and I was very interested in knowing that how we can go into the rural communities or even, you know, solve the problems using digital as a space. Definitely the understanding of digital before the fellowship was quite limited for me, but after the fellowship I can say that it has a whole new spectrum where you can use digital as a tool. So I think that was the inspiration, and it definitely made me understand a whole new perspective about digital. I think I won't say any specific key milestone, but my milestone is like an amalgamation of all the little victories or milestone I feel I encountered. That even that means like accommodating myself in a land which was different to me in terms of language and other communication barriers. Able to travel to all these places now on my own and to learn about communities, to be able to articulate how it happens, what it happens. And I think the ability to articulate and document these kind of things have increased for me, which is definitely, I think, personal, as a personal growth is a key milestone to me. I think the biggest challenge initially started with the language barrier, because most of the people here are Tamil speaking people, and I used to lean on the people around initially for translation. But with time I understood that definitely language is still a barrier for me when I travel alone. But that's the beauty about language, you know, so much expression is attached to it that I guess most of the time I'm communicating, understanding, or maybe, you know, they are understanding me based on my expression, and I guess it's going pretty nice. So that's a challenge I think I have overcome, not purely in whole sense, but yeah, somewhere. And apart from that, it's a new place to start a project with, so it's a little challenging to make people understand what your vision is and to get them on board with you, because I think it's very obvious that they can't trust somebody who just came from outside. And I think, but that is a process of how you hold patience and you work with communities on a daily basis, or you know, you try to make them comfortable. So I think that was a challenge initially, but now it's a smooth ride. I think think my understanding of digital before the fellowship included that, you know, we usually see that how tech can be used in space or social sector, and that includes all the tools of tech, be it your computer, laptop, smartphones, Wi-Fi, etc. But when during my fellowship, and now when it's getting wrapped, I can say that there are so many layers to digital, and there are so many layers of digital that affect the society today in good or in a bad manner. And it's very important that we understand those layers and communicate the same to the rural communities, because we are privileged enough to carry resources with us that can be very useful for them. That includes as something as basic as online safety. You know, many places we see that people are getting trapped into this online fraud and all. So, you know, for them, that is like such a hard earned money. So that is a layer to it, which comes to the digital space. And then whole new dimension of how you can make policies around digital space that can help the rural communities. So I think that understanding have definitely broadened with the fellowship. I think when it comes to the positive impact, it's extremely delightful feeling to see people coming to the clusters, taking the full you know, benefit of the services that are made for them, the workshop that are made for them. So I've met women of all these communities. Right now I'm shooting this video from Pattamadai. I see all those young girls coming to the center for their digital literacy classes, digital design classes, for their tailoring, for the mat weaving. So when you see all those, and when I've talked to them, I think most of them, they don't leave house after their school hours or something, and it's a little bit restricted atmosphere also. But trusting a cluster and coming to that space, or the families who are trusting to send their daughters, and those daughters extremely, you know, elated and infectious personalities and smile those girls carry. So I think that is something that you see and you feel really inspired, and that gives some motivation also, you know, that to continue in the space that you're working. So definitely that's a positive, many positive impacts are there, but one of them that I can quote just right now what I saw. I think at a personal level, there are a list of lessons that I have learned. As throughout my video, I've said a lot about communities. I've learned the sense of kindness, patience, and empathy these people carry. I've traveled to rural communities, and the sense of giving even when you don't have enough is something which is so big. And I think I have tried to imbibe that, and I want to take it forward in my life and implement it in a good manner. And the humble nature of the people around you working is definitely something that you want to, you know, take forward. So yeah, those has been the good parts. To all the fellows who will be joining the second batch, I think I would like to say that this is a great opportunity to get on board, to experience something which is truly, you know, new to what we always think in terms of digital and social sector. The amalgamation is something that you can, you know, literally utilize to broaden your perspective and work on the field in terms of bringing any sort of difference and also cultivating yourself as an individual. So to whomsoever is going to be a part of this or want to be a part of this, definitely give yourself this chance, because I think it's a pretty interesting journey. You will learn a lot of things. You will meet a lot of people. You will see that, you know, many things are have a definition of ours, but when you go out, you see that, you know, there are so many elements that get attached to it. And at the end, I think it's a lot to your personal growth as an individual. That is what matters. So yeah, whoever wants to join and is going to be a part of this, good luck to everyone.